want to know, boys, is as a defender, when do your eyes light up? If a defender starts here, is that what you want most? Or if he stands here, is that where you feel less comfortable? Where do you feel most comfortable where a defender stands?
It sort of depends. Each club, sort of, they're either back shoulder or assertive. I'd probably more like the assertive defender, be able to get in behind them and lead from there is probably the way that I go.
And so, Josh, at the same time that Aaron's deciding that here, you may be a little bit deeper. What are you thinking about the positioning with Aaron in terms of where you should be at that stage?
Yeah, well, you obviously want to have a good separation between the two of you, and you don't want to be going for the same footy. And you want to be giving the kicker different options. So, say, if Aaron's coming up at the footy, and I want to be the one out calling for it a little bit longer, right, pulling it in. So normally having one going at the kicker and one filling in behind in the space behind.
And do you worry a little bit when you're caught under the footy knowing he's behind you and what he's going to do? Because at the moment, yes, he's flying at absolutely everything.
Yeah, yeah. I'm not worried, no.
Tim English is a little bit worried.
Tim English will definitely be worried. But, yeah, well, that's what you've got to expect when you're playing with a once-in-a-generational talent like my friend here. So I'm happy to get a few on the head as long as he's marking them.
So are there times when you're both in the middle, just 15 metres out from the goal square, and that little present-up thing's been a little more obvious this year because of the man-on-the-mark rule? Is that something you're looking for as well and aware of, especially at stop plays in around forward of centre?
Yeah, definitely. Just those sort of held balls 60 to 70 metres out from goal, we sort of come together down near the goal square and sort of queued up and work for each other and try and aim for only one of us to fly and the rest of the forwards work for that bloke to get him free. So hopefully that's a good look at it.
And what about the tactics that your immediate opponent will use, but then other defenders that get back down there and those little blocks to stop your run at the footy? What are some of the things you try to do to don't allow them to block your run and jump at the ball?
For myself, it's probably a hitting late. Hit the defender late, so then once I do hit them, then I'm right to...
So get a little bit of separation?
Yeah, separation, and then sort of timing of the footy is my strength. So once I can pick up the early read of the flight of the footy and then hit, and then by the time I'm off, that separation's
and
hard.
And while we're getting your answer, Josh, I'm sure you've got something to say on Wayne's question then. We'll head to the boundary. So how do you sum that up?
Yeah, well, I think defenders are so good these days at rolling off. So say if one of the smalls puts a block on my direct opponent, then another defender will be ready to try and intercept. And it's what you see a lot in footy is the forwards getting held down, blocked, and one of the defenders coming across. That's really important, as Aaron said, to have that timing and try and fight through it as best you can. You know, just bring it to ground as a win for a key forward in that situation. So.
All right, now come over here, guys. Just want to ask you this situation. We're enamoured with this in the commentary box about where you guys decide is the cut-off point for kicking around the corner. So we know a lot of you prefer, and you guys like, you're a bit old style, you both like to kick drop punts, I know. But where is the cut-off point for kicking around the corner or kicking a drop punt? Is it 25 metres? What is it for you, Aaron?
Probably don't have a set distance. Probably on this side as a left footer, I'm more likely to do the drop punt from further out because I probably don't have the distance on my right foot snap. But probably on the other side of the pocket, I'm probably snapping all the way out to about 30 metres.
What do you think of Josh?
Yeah, I'm similar to Aaron. I think as left foot dominant player, I'd struggle to get this much distance on my right foot, so I'd go for a left foot check side from this position, so a banana.
Yep.
But if I was in tight, probably within 5 or 10 metres of the point post, I'd use my right foot and work the angle a little bit better.
And you're kicking the ball really well at the moment for goal. Not so well, Aaron. You're doing everything else beautifully. But you self-assess. If you do miss one, automatically the next mark you take, you go back and do you say to yourself, OK, you know exactly what you did wrong the shot before? Self-assess on the run?
Yeah, a little bit. I think I've been really good. Bruce's been really good at helping me out. We're really routine-based down there, so... whenever we do take a mark, we make sure we try to get to each other and tell us to go through our routine and take our time. I don't really get too fussed if I miss a goal. I know that my routine's solid enough that I'm going to kick the next one, so I'm not too stressed out about it. But, yeah, it would be nice to nail more than I made them.
All right, boys, we've just run out a bit of time, so good luck to both of you tonight. And we will be watching you very closely, won't we, Dan?
Excited to watch.
Yes, good luck.
Thanks, boys. You.